Hi there, my name is Hillary Walsh. I'm an immigration lawyer in Phoenix, Arizona. My law firm is New Frontier Immigration Law. You know, one of the things that I enjoy most about life is working. I just am one of those people who enjoys going to work. I enjoy helping people. I enjoy the job that I get to do. And I find that a lot of my clients are really similarly structured. They like working. An important part of working in the United States is having work authorization. So, interested in that, this video is for you. I'm going to give you 5 quick tips about work authorization that you may not know. First is that if you do pretty much any filing with USCIS, so if you are getting married to a U.S. citizen and you're receiving work authorization through that, or if you are filing a new visa and you've actually sent it off and it's, you know, it's been approved, then you're going to get your work authorization several months after filing. A marriage-based filing is going to take you about 8 months for you to get that initial work authorization. The same is true as if you're in immigration court and you file a 42B application. So you've been here in the United States for about 10 years with qualifying relatives. You'll get your work authorization roughly about 8 months after you file. So that's so you know that the general time frame for when you get that. It can be much shorter. That doesn't mean that your case is over and you can't continue to file for work authorization. You actually can. So pre-Trump administration, there were a lot of cases that were routinely closed, called administrative closure. So if that was something that happened for you here in the United States, you're not really in proceedings still, and so you don't know how to go about getting your work authorization, give us a call. We can help you with that. We've been helping several people with that exact issue just this month, and it's only the 10th of March. Okay, the next kind of fun tip is that if your case is on appeal, and even if you've never filed for work authorization before, if your case is on appeal, we can help you. You don't have to be in front of the immigration court or in front of USCIS to make that initial first filing. We can help you while your case is on appeal getting the work authorization, so you're able to work throughout the course of your immigration. One other tip, and this, these two are kind of connected, is that renewing your work authorization is actually going to be a process that's faster than if you were applying for it for a brand new work authorization. Okay, so sometimes replacing is even faster than renewing. So there are different nuances, and you can definitely visit with us about the proper way of going about it to make sure that accurate and also is beneficial to you. The last tip is, and this is so important, is that work authorization, that card, can help you go to the driver's license, to the DMV, and get your driver's license. A lot of people don't realize that until their driver's license is about to expire and their work authorization is about to expire. They have to wait that several months lag before they get their work authorization in the mail, and then they're out of the driver's license. Days where you can't fly without specific requirements for IDs. It's so important for you to have all of your documents in order, and none of this can really be rushed. So I encourage you, if you're needing work authorization or you think you might need to renew it, or perhaps you've never had it and you think that some of these things may be helpful, and I encourage you to give us a call. We're New Frontier Immigration Law, and our phone number is 623-742-5400. Hillary Walsh, I look forward to helping you get your work off.